Boom. Okay, we'll go this way a little bit. All right, so here's what you need. We have our cute little computers. You're gonna get an opportunity to use these computers, right? We can hook them up to a lot of different accessories. Now, the accessory we're gonna use today is going to be our colorimeter. Our colorimeter is this little machine here that is going to help us get the value of how much light is absorbed by our pigments. As you can see, you've made your blue things. If you haven't completed, it's okay. But we got several levels, from the darkest of the blue to the lightest of the blue and to water being clear, okay? This has zero absorbance. This is gonna be the most absorbance, and you should see your numbers stepwise going up like that. Let me go back to, So what we gotta do is we have to set up our colorimeter. That is the first thing. So while you're waiting for me, let's go ahead and turn on your vernier. I call it your little computers, and plug in your colorimeter. It needs to warm up for 90 seconds. So I figure while I fiddle around and get what I need to get, it's gonna be doing that. And by the way, you guys are scot-free at this point. The hardest part of this whole thing was making the blue juice, the copper sulfate pentahydrate. So, please forgive, I'm still trying to, for some reason I exited out of my lab. Week two, lab four. Download. All right, my friends, we're back. So turn to page, should be page 6 from my memory. I don't know, let's see how good I am. Nope, I'm not good. It's page 7. Oh, darn. All right, so it even tells you, plug in your colorimeter. I'm looking at page 7. Number 2, allow 90 seconds for warm up. Number 3, make sure your colorimeter is set at 635 nanometers. You guys have the awesome ones. Everybody has these ones, right? Nobody has anything different from this? That group, check me out. Is this the one you have? Okay, cool. Make sure that it's set, you can see the light on it, at 635 nanometers. Okay, so that is the spectrum of light that is going to be put through. There is a spectrum of light, all light that is going to come from the sun. Okay, energy comes from the sun. Now, there's a smaller spectrum of energy that comes from the sun that is called light energy. And within that light energy, there's even smaller spectrums. So when you look at a rainbow, there's all these different colors within a rainbow. What causes that is going to be the refraction of light. And so sometimes when you see a rainbow and you only see a half a rainbow, you're like, where's all the good colors? Do you ever see that? Because some of those colors are not being refracted for you to see. And what is refraction? Refraction is the opposite of absorption. If it is not absorbing, it's refracting or reflecting, okay? So that's basically a quick little overview about what those nanometers mean. It just means the amount of light. You're like, why did I do a quick overview? You have a whole photosynthesis chapter. You'll get a chance to hear about that again, okay? Alrighty. So we just need to set up our colorimeter. And in order to set up your colorimeter, I don't see it on here. I'll just write it down. I'm not sure where it says it, but I will just write it. So you're gonna go into your colorimeter, use your little stylus right here, and with your little stylus, click on it. Click on the top where it says File, and then hit New. If nothing happens, that's great. What that means is somebody dumped the last information that was used. I always do that before I get started, okay? Then I'm gonna go into the right-hand side. On the right-hand side, you should see something that says duration. And right now it says 300 seconds. Do you guys see that? Okay, change that 300 seconds to 10 seconds. And you do that by tapping on it. Tap on it. And then go into the duration, 10 seconds. Don't worry about the rate. Don't worry about the intervals. Just change it to 10 seconds. And then hit OK. That way it saves it. Yeah? It is. Absorbance is happening right now, so don't worry about it. Yeah, because he got it closed, and yeah, you're good. You're good, and it's absorbing the black inside. All right, so once you've hit save, you should see it now says 10 seconds. It should have saved it. All right, we're ready to roll. It's set. That's all you needed to do. Oh, I lie. I'm such a fibber. Oh, my gosh, the most important thing of all. Well, we have to calibrate it, and you're going to calibrate it using your water, okay? You're like, how am I going to get this test tube in here? You're not going to get that test tube in there. What you're going to do is you're going to take your little cuvettes. May I see that, please, Richard? See these little cuvettes? They're really cute. You're going to, and when you number them, number them on the lid, okay? Do not number them on the sides or anything. When you number them on the lid, what you're going to do is you're going to transfer liquid from here into here. Label it number one. Fill it up. Not quite like more than 3/4. I would say, yes, 7/8. I like that. About 7/8. Fill it up like that. Always have a lid. Always have a lid. Okay. Then you're going to clean it off. I need tissue paper. Once you have your liquid in there, and we're doing the water first. There we go. Tissue paper for everybody. I'm going to pass it out so don't go to waste. You have serrated side, and then you have the smooth side. Make sure you are cleaning off the smooth side so it doesn't get fingerprints, because that can affect your readings, okay? You can touch the serrated side. Then you are going to put it in the colorimeter with the smooth sides facing side to side, because that's where the light goes. Put it in there. Place it down. You should do it down anyway. Close it up. We have to calibrate it. Hold the calibration button until the red stops flashing. Alrighty, let's write that down. Set duration, and then we're gonna go ahead and calibrate. Calibrate, how do you spell calibrate? I'm over here trying to celebrate. Calibrate, there we go. With water, which is number one. Alrighty. Now you're ready to take measurements. So watch me. This is very important because people go wrong here. This is water. Pretend this has blue juice in it because I took number two, whoop, put it in there up to 7/8, right? Cleaned it off. Boom, boom, boom. Put it in the colorimeter. Closed it. Lid is on there too, by the way. Never hit calibrate again. Don't hit calibrate again. You'll end up with all zeros for your answer because you'll keep telling your computer that that's zero. So only hit calibrate when you do the first one. Yay, water only. So then you, on the next ones, you want to take a reading. Little old-timey VCR, you guys have seen them in museums, okay? You hit the play button right there. You hit play. And it's going to run for 10 seconds because you set it for 10 seconds. And then let it run, let it run, let it run. Okay. When it stops, it's going to give you a value. And that value is in the top corner, and it's called absorbance. Get that number. Write it down. That's telling you how much is being absorbed, how much light is being absorbed in nanometers. You do that for every one. When do you calibrate? Water. Do you calibrate every time you do another one of these? Yeah. No, only the first time. All right. You're good.